I'm back. Rodrance for the Matrix and Road Show. We're going to talk about Corey Feldman. Now, Corey Feldman was an actor, a child actor. We covered him a lot, actually. John covered him a lot when he was John Talks Movies. I covered him a lot when I was Rhodes Rants. Well, I'm still Rhodes Rants, but you get the point over on my channel. Corey Feldman, of course, was a child star in a lot of blockbuster movies. Goonies, Lost Boys, Gremlins, Dream a Little Dream, License to Drive, and of course, for me, oh, and he was also in Stand By Me. And for me, really and truly, he stood out because he played Tommy Jarvis in Friday the 13th, Part 4, The Final Chapter. Now, Tommy Jarvis was the first of the quote-unquote Jarvis trilogy, okay, where Tommy Jarvis took on Jason Voorhees. They tried to get Corey back for Part 5, A New Beginning. I don't even think Corey would have saved that movie, but he did come back and have a cameo. He could not actually star in that movie because he had a scheduling conflict. They were doing Goonies. So he wasn't able to come back and be in that role. Well, now there's news that's come out there. And last year we covered him. He released the documentary, My Truth. And I can't say the full name of that because YouTube will frown. And but of course, we found out he accused Charlie Sheen of some really nefarious activities with his now deceased buddy, Corey Haim. Well, Corey Feldman came out and made some comments, and it looks like he's talking about hanging up the old acting chops. Now look, if you ain't really plugged into Corey Feldman, you may be thinking, didn't he retire a long time ago? Well, no, Corey Feldman has still been acting. He's turned into more of a C-list actor. Some could even say a D-list actor at this point. But he's come out and he's saying he's retiring. Corey Feldman now says he's officially retiring from acting. This is the old guys over at DreadCentral.com. In a recent interview celebrating his 50th birthday, Corey Feldman says he may never make another film again. Corey Feldman doesn't think he wants to make another film like ever again. In a recent video interview with MovieWeb, the 80s icon had some choice words for Hollywood and why he's ready to leave it all behind. Don't get him wrong, though. If the right legacy project came knocking, he'd still consider The Lost Boys, The Goonies, Friday the 13th, and Stand By Me are just a drop in the bucket for the genre star. Even though he hasn't provided a stellar content since the 90s, that doesn't mean he doesn't deserve a call from any of the above. By the way, he was also in the sequel, I believe, Tales from the Crypt. It was that Bordello of Blood? I'm not sure. I can't remember. In the video interview celebrating his 50th birthday, the actor shared some pretty heavy insight into where he's at professionally. Quote, as far as the film front goes, yes, I've got a couple of cameos. There's a couple of cameos on the way out, but they're very brief, and that's it. I have not decided if I want to make another film. I have literally taken this as a giant reset. That's what this is all about. The 50-year mark for me is saying, half my life is now over. How do I want to spend the other half? And that's going to unfold as the days present themselves, and I can't tell you what the future holds. The Friday the 13th Part 4 protagonist also spotlights why he's in the position he's in. He recently reported on another interview where the star expressed feelings that he was screwed over by horror producers and didn't seem like they were isolated incidents. I can't tell you that I'll ever star in another movie. I haven't decided if I want to or not, because I have dedicated a lot of my life and my career to filmmaking. I feel like that I've been a bit overlooked. I don't know that I want to dedicate any more of my life to something where I am not appreciated. I know that there's appreciation for my past acting work. I'm not saying that there's not. I really don't see myself begging for work. Yikes, he's saying he's just not getting any opportunities, basically. The interview does mention legacy titles Feldman is interested in pursuing. Should the right opportunity come along, he name checks Friday the 13th and Goonies as properties he would be willing to revisit. Now, something I gotta also mention is there's been some Friday the 13th documentaries made. In fact, I normally go back and watch it every year. Not only do I have a film marathon, but I watch the documentary. And it's several hours long. And Corey Feldman actually hosts that documentary. I think Corey Feldman would jump at the chance to rekindle his relationship with Tommy Jarvis. And I don't know that he would be the actor necessarily that they would go to. My gut feeling is he would be. Now, from a Friday the 13th fan, that's Tom Matthews' role, in my opinion. He owned it in Jason Lives. I think he played an awesome version of Tommy Jarvis. But I wouldn't be against Corey Feldman coming back and revising and replaying that role one more time for the fans. It would be nice. I think it's pretty easy to read between the lines here. If he got another opportunity to play in one of these old roles, we know he's done some of these Lost Boys kind of straight to video kind of flicks, he would of course come back and jump all over being in Friday the 13th. So he's always got something controversial going on. I kind of went against the grain. I didn't fully buy into everything he said in his documentary. I said, I think we need to pull back. We need some more facts to come out. Charlie Sheen came out and categorically denied everything he said. Now, I will say this. Corey Feldman got pretty detailed in what happened involving Charlie Sheen and Corey Haim. And it was some repugnant-ass behavior, let me tell you. It was nasty. But there was nothing saying for sure that absolutely something happened there. And one of the problems there was, look, Corey Feldman doesn't have the strongest past in the world, okay, or track record. This is coming from a Corey Feldman fan. But I gotta call it like I see it, right? So, will he stop acting? On a percentage scale, there's a 1% chance he's going to quit acting. I don't believe this for a second. If the right project comes around, particularly one that could relaunch his career, I think he'd be all over it. You know, it's kind of weird. Corey Feldman's one of those guys that you always got to wonder if somebody like that's a big fan of genre, like Quentin Tarantino, would ever reach out to him and could relaunch his career in the way he once relaunched John Travolta's. But, point of fact, John Travolta was a much, much bigger star back in the 70s and 80s than Corey Feldman was. Sorry, Corey, but that's just a fact. Peace. I'm out. Till next time.